In this video, we are discussing network layer IPv4 classful addressing. In IPv4 classful addressing, the address space is divided into 5 different classes. They are A, B, C, D, and E. In the previous video, we have discussed that what is IPv4. That is, we are having this one, a 32-bit addressing format, and all the nodes in the network connected should have the unique non-conflict addresses. So all the addresses will be unique. So as a result of that, there will be no conflict and no ambiguity. Now let us go for the what are the classes, the class details. In case of class A, we are having this first 8 bits, that is first byte, this one will be containing the net ID, and rest 3 bytes, that is 24 bits, will be containing the host ID. Host ID means the computer ID, and net ID means network ID. So next one, in class B, the first 2 bytes will be for the net ID and rest will be for host ID. This is my class C, so 24 bits for the net ID and last bit for the host ID. In this way, class A, class B and class C is there. And here we are having the class D and class E. Okay, now see, in case of class A, the first bit will be 0, and that is permanent, that is not getting changed. So the first bit is 0. So we are having flexibility in the last 7 bits. So the last 7 bits can have all 7 zeros minimum. So in total all 8 zeros, so that will be 0 there. Last 7 bits can have all 1 bits there as maximum. So 7 number of 1 means it will be denoting 127. So that's why this particular net ID will be ranging from 0 to 127. In this case, 10 is the permanent for the first 2 bits. So how many bits we are having here in the first byte? Remaining 6 bits. So what is the minimum value here? All 6 zeros means what is the total byte? 1 and then 7 zeros. What is the value then? 128. Okay, now 6 bits 1 means what? 6 bits 1 means it is 63. So this is 128 plus 63, I am getting this one as 191. Here we are having the first 3 bits 110, that is permanent. What is 1? Here is 128, and this one, that is 64. Then what is the value here? 128 plus 64. What is that? 192. How many bits are there remaining? 5 bits. What is the minimum value for them? All 5 zeros. Then what will be the total value in that case? 11 and then 6 zeros, that is 192. This we are having here, 5 zeros we are having here. So 5 zeros means what is the maximum value it can have? 5 times 1 means what? That is 131. So 192 plus 31, that is 223. So in this way the things are coming. So if you can remember all these things, you can easily regenerate it in your exam hall. But you are supposed to remember this 0, 10 and 110. Here we are having this class D. It is having the first 4 bits 1110, and it will be ranging in this way. So that is 224 plus 15, that is 139. In this way also you can calculate the same. So the first 4 bits 1 means 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16. So that is 240. And here 4 bits can have values ranging from 4 zeros to 41, that means 0 to 15. So 240 plus 15 is 255. In this way, you can easily find that this is our binary notation and this is our dotted decimal notation, also known as dotted quad notation. So this is my classifications we are having. So it will be denoting the network ID, and they will be denoting the respective host ID or the computer IDs. And all these computers should have unique IPv4 addressing. So now here you can consider A, we are having the number of blocks is equal to 128, and here number of blocks is equal to 128. Why we are having number of blocks is equal to 128? Because here we are having 7 bits, remaining first bit is 0 permanently. So 7 bits can range from 7 number of zeros to 7 number 1, that means 0 to 127. And that means 128 number of blocks. And here 128 number of blocks. So how many bits will be there for the host ID? We are having 3 into 8, 24 bits. Then what is 24? That is, how many combinations are possible using 24 bits? That is 2 to the power of 4 into 2 to the power of 10 into 2 to the power of 10. So 2 to the power of 10 means 1K. 1K into 1K means 1 mega. and 2 to the power of 4 means 16. So 16 mega number of hosts or the computers can exist in class A, and it has been expressed here, and it is required for unit cost. Next one, for this one, just think here. Here we are having how many bits are remaining? 6. How many bits are remaining here? 8. So 6 plus 8, what is the value then? 6 plus 8 is equal to 14. So here we will be having 16k. Why 14 has become 16k? Because 14 bits can have 2 to the power of 14 combinations. What is 2 to the power of 14? 2 to the power of 4 into 2 to the power of 10. What is 2 to the power of 4? 16. 2 to the power of 10? 1024. Means 1k means 16k. In this way, the values are coming. And how many bits are you having here for the host? We are having 8 plus 8, 16 bits. So what is 16? That is 2 to the power of 6, 64. And 2 to the power of 10 is 1k. That means 64k. And really, it is 64k. You might be asking me, it is not 64k, it is 65536. Obviously, because 2 to the power of 10 is not 1000, it is also 1024. And it will be required for this unicast. So if you follow my logic, here you see we are having 8 bits for the host ID. So how many combinations are we expecting using 8 bits? 2 to the power of 8, that means what? 256. So everything is logical. So remember this particular table, and here we are against this particular classes. So number of blocks and block size in the classful IP before addressing. Number of blocks means how many number of net IDs, and block size means per net ID how many number of nodes we can install. And here you see, in case of class A, the first 8 bits will be denoting the net ID and rest bits will be denoting the respective host ID. So that's why subnet marks will be 255. What is 255? Means 8 number of ones. So 255.0.0.0. So wherever the bits will be denoting the net ID, in the subnet mask we are putting 1. Whenever this bit is denoting the host ID, there is a computer number, in the subnet mask we will be putting 0. So that's why the subnet mask has become 255.0.0. And also it can be expressed in the form of slash 8 notation. That means the first 8 bits will be denoting the respective net ID. Here we are having 2 bytes for the net ID. So in the subnet mask it will be 8 bits 1 and 8 bits 1. And then we are having 8 bits 0 and 8 bits 0, and they will be denoting the respective number of nodes. So it will be denoted by 8 times 1, 8 times 1, and then 8 times 0 and 8 times 0. So 255.255.0.0. How many bits are there to denoting the net ID? 16 bits. So this is known as the slash notation. So in that way also we can express. And this is our CID, also known as this. So this is my, how many bits are there? Here we are having 24 bits. So slash 24 255.255.255.0 will be the subnet mask. In classful addressing, a good number of available address combinations are wasted. So this classful addressing have become obsolete and has been replaced by the classless addressing. In the next videos, we'll be discussing on the classless addressing in this chapter. You can watch that one and watch all the videos in this particular chapter in the sequence to have a good idea what is IPv4 and IPv6. Thanks for watching this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.